Three Daniels.
One man is missing. Two girls lie dead, and somebody is on the other end of the phone. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid.
Who is it?
Reed Daniels. Come in.
Bree Daniels, girl on the brink. Somewhere among her clientele is a freak who murders call girls.
Sit down.
And a wholly incredible cop who insists her life is worth saving.
I don't think he's going to come back again.
I just don't want to be alone right now.
Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid.
What else do you remember about the man who beat you up?
Nothing. Except that he wasn't kidding, that's all.
But you cannot identify this man as Tom Gruneman.
I can't identify him as anybody.
Give me your hand. There's someone on the roof.
Would you like my friend Frankie?
Not very much. Hey. Your tapes.
Golly gee, just what I've always wanted. Dirty phone calls. Is Mr. Goldfarb there? I've got to talk to somebody. I'm just a little way across town. Can I come over?
Detective Trask, please. Hiya, John Clute. He didn't take the plane. He canceled out. Well, I think this man killed Jane McKenna and killed Arlen Page. I think he drowned them. I think you should prepare yourself for the fact that possibly Tom is dead. But the only way I'm going to find out is to find him.
All right, fine. I'll notify the board as soon as I get to Chicago.
When organized crime becomes so clever that the police are forced to take desperate measures, it becomes hard to tell the cops from the killers.
Quick, Bobby! Bobby, get him!
Roy Scheider, in The French Connection, he helped to crack a $32 million dope ring. Now he's back, leading a new team of undercover super cops, even more ruthless than the mob they're gunning for. The 7-Ups. The dirty trick squad that even the regular police are afraid of.
Who shot the policeman in your car?
I'm hurt bad.
Who shot your car, Mike?
They bust you. They break you. They make you beg for a nice safe stretch in prison, 7 years and up.
Who were those guys that shot my partner in the back seat of the car? The guy you iced was a cop.
Okay, so he was a cop.
Now, from the producer of Bullet and The French Connection, a high-speed ride with the strong arm of the law. It's a matter of kill or be killed. And once the 7-Ups are on your tail, there's only one way to get them off. The producer of Bullet and The French Connection brings you the ultimate chase in the 7-Ups.
Los Angeles, 1937. There are lots of guys like J.J. Gittes. They're easy to find, if you want to find them.
Mr. Gittes, have we ever met?
Well, no.
Never?
Never.
Since you agree with me that we've never met before, you must also agree with me that I've never hired you to do anything, certainly not spy on my husband. I don't get tough with anyone, Mr. Gittes. My lawyer does.
You do your job, and sometimes you find the answers to questions that should never be asked. Or you find out what happens to people who ask them.
Hold it there, kitty cat.
You're a very nosy fellow, kitty cat, huh? You know what happens to nosy fellows?
I dislike the word cheat.
Did you have affairs?
Mr. Gittes.
Did he know about it? Where were you when your husband died? You were seeing someone, too. For very long?
I don't see anyone for very long, Mr. Gittes. It's difficult for me.
Mr. Gittes, you're dealing with a disturbed woman who's just lost her husband. I don't want to take an advantage of.
Close to the truth. Jack Nicholson and Faye Dunaway in a Robert Evans production of a Roman Polanski film, Chinatown.
The city is Istanbul. The time is the 30s. The people are famous.
Monsieur Hercule Poirot, the famous.
Precisely. Famous and infamous. Some are conspicuous by choice. Some are insignificant by nature. Others are incognito by right.
On the Orient Express. How well?
Ladies and gentlemen, you're in distinguished company. Moreover, you're in dangerous company. For you're about to join Hercule Poirot, the international detective no less, in the most celebrated whodunit ever conceived by the mastermind of Agatha Christie.
You must solve the mystery.
How did you know it was a man?
Because I've enjoyed very warm relationships with both my husbands.
Did you leave your room?
Nay, not till morning, in my bedgown.
He had the means to do it.
It was found in an ashtray by the dead man's bedside.
Then someone planted it there.
He did it. The butler did it.
Seems like I'm kind of incriminating myself.
Not now. Not now. When it's all over, when it's behind us, then.
When what was all over, Miss Dillon?
Am I to be accused of hiding it in my suitcase?
My life has been threatened, Mr. Perot. And I... let me show you this.
Starring Albert Finney, Lauren Bacall, Martin Balsam, Ingrid Bergman, Jacqueline Bisset, Jean-Pierre Cassel, Sean Connery, John Gielgud, Wendy Hillam, Anthony Perkins, Vanessa Redgrave, Rachel Roberts, Richard Widmark, Michael York. So many stars. Together, they comprise the most entertaining ensemble who ever gathered to play their part in murder.
Is Harper. And the Harper days are here again.
I am required by law to advise you guys that my hands are registered in the state of California as lethal weapons. You understand?
Black belt, huh?
You betcha.
McGlow, show him yours.
Well, it's a different ballgame. I was just kidding. I'm a brown belt.
Warner Brothers and First Artist presents Paul Newman as Harper. In the drowning pool.
I spotted your car.
You spotted my car? Would it wash off?
Rivage, Louisiana is hot and damp, and things get rotten fast. So it was no surprise to Harper when a simple case of blackmail became a messy case of murder.
What you doing here?
Well, I was walking down the street.
You were seen in a state of undress in a motel room. With an underage girl.
The door was unlocked.
Who did the seeing?
I did.
Was it Iris or was it Frank's?
Bull.
Bull what?
You got nothing in there.
Was it one of Jay Hughes' pranks?
It's not nice to look up ladies' dresses.
Or was it Mavis who took Harper for a dip in the drowning pool?
I ran a check on you, Mr. Harper. You are not stupid.
I have my moments.
A case with too many clues has Harper singing the blues. Because Harper days are mystery days, happy days and action days, bayou days and bygone days, shady days, funny days, sexy days, whodunit days, days more fun than you remember when. Harper days are here again.
Why are we whispering?
Paul Newman is just a guy trying to keep his head above water, and now he's in the drowning pool.
Michelangelo Antonioni, one of the great film artists of this generation, now takes you on a fascinating and spellbinding journey into identity. Jack Nicholson is the reporter, famous, powerful, respected, and a haunted, driven, desperate man. Maria Schneider, the sensual young star of Last Tango in Paris, is the girl who ran with him and for him.
What are you running away from?
The passenger, a man who's just found a way out. He's changed places with a dead man.
We are sure, doctor's report. Your husband died from a heart attack.
And he is about to begin an odyssey that will take him into that man's life and fate.
Robertson is involved in illegal arms traffic in our country.
I just sold 5,000 hand grenades, 900 rifles, and a great deal of ammunition to some people fighting a secret war in an obscure part of the world.
A world that will never look the same again.
Let's go.
All right!
The brilliance of Jack Nicholson. The beauty of Maria Schneider. The vision of Antonioni. The Passenger.
I think Harry would like me to leave.
Well, I don't think that's necessary.
I think Harry thinks it is.
Harry thinks if you call him Harry one more time, he's going to make you eat that cat. Gene Hackman. Is Harry Mosby.
Hello, Harry.
In Night Moves.
Well, come on, take a swing at me, Harry, the way Sam Spade would.
He's a private investigator.
My daughter, Dally. Would you believe Delilah? Well, she's gone.
How long gone?
2 weeks. Go find her.
Making a living.
Well, let's say $125 a day in legitimate expenses.
From other people's lives.
You can get cheaper.
Can I get better? You're hired.
Making a mess of his own.
God, you're really prime, Ellen, you know that? I catch you screwing another guy and you attack my lifestyle!
Your lifestyle has nothing to do with it!
Night Moves. It's a mystery.
I'm looking for Dally Grassner.
Dally isn't around here anymore.
With a suspect. Are also the victims.
I want to know what I walked into. Ask your wife.
Well, are we going to talk about it?
Well, it's your ball, run with it.
Where the questions.
All right, what's it all about, Mosby?
Is there still much smuggling going on around here?
The dogs have fleas.
Where were you when Kennedy got shot?
Have too many answers. Where every clue is a lie.
I've been listening to your ping pong talk long enough. What was in Marv Ellman's plane? Drugs? Was it drugs?
Night Moves.
Check.
Check.
Ah, it's a beauty.
It's a game where every player is a pawn.
Harry Mosby, isn't it?
Every move is a wrong one. And the winner loses everything.
I want to know what it's all about.
I told you what it's all about.
You, what the hell are you all about?
You're asking the wrong question.
Gene Hackman in Night Moves.
To begin with, trust no one.
Don't.
And believe half
outside
of what you see. Because nothing is as it appears. And nobody is who they seem to be.
He needs what?
Now, from the master of action, suspense, and surprises, Charles Bronson in Alistair MacLean's Breakheart Pass. All that lies between Fort Humboldt and the nearest town is 400 miles of frozen desolation, connected by a thin lifeline of steel. And all that lies between the men of Fort Humboldt and death are the people on this train. But are the people on this train on a mission of mercy or murder?
Nobody heard anything, nobody saw anything. Nobody knows anything.
Deacon is right, Dr. Molyneux was murdered.
Looks like somebody knocked him out, stuck a thin surgical probe up under his ribs.
I can't find the Reverend.
Telegraph line to Myrtle no longer works.
Someone is trying to stop this train.
Oh, my God!
Hey, we're going backwards!
Be on this train for a while. We just might find out what happened before we have to get off.
There's a conspiracy on board this train that goes beyond murder. But who is part of it? And who is expendable? The answer waits at Alistair MacLean's Breakheart Pass. Because nothing is as it appears, and nobody is who they seem to be.
He told us what he's not, but not what he is.
George Caldwell is taking the Silver Streak to Chicago.
First class? Yes, sir. Right this way.
He's a busy publisher who's taking a train for one reason only.
I just want to be bored.
Come on. Well, you're in for the ride of your life.
Yeah.
You just pick out a little chickie, my friend, and it's hugging munch all the way to Chicago.
What do you publish?
Oh, mostly nonfiction. Cookbooks, how-to-do-it books.
It's very interesting. Are you married?
Divorced.
But in the next 3 days, he will fall in love. He will witness a murder. And become involved in a bizarre international intrigue.
All right, listen, Buster, you're in trouble. And I mean big trouble, because I'm reporting you. All right, enough's enough. If you're willing to forget it, I don't believe this. Are you kidding?
From an innocent passenger, George Caldwell will become a victim. A man who will be forced to risk his life in order to save it.
Hold it! Don't move or I'll shoot!
He will fall into possession of the priceless Rembrandt papers and into a perfect frame-up for murder.
Holy moly, you shot him!
All right, mister. Just keep your hands where they are and we'll have no trouble.
Give me that! Don't shoot!
He will make a friend.
Who are you? I'm a thief, man. What do you want you for anyway, man?
Murder.
Drop me off anywhere along in here, okay? I don't mess with the big end.
And become a fugitive from the law, wanted in every state.
Wait right here. Go get the tickets and it's goodbye, George.
What are you talking about? Well, how are we gonna get on the train?
Got an idea.
I can't pass for black.
Who you telling? I didn't say I was gonna make you black. I said I was gonna get you on the train.
It's comedy.
That's my man. I don't think we'll make it past the cops.
We'll make it past the cops. I just hope we don't see no Muslims.
It's romance.
You've got shoe polish behind your ear.
And adventure in the runaway suspense hit of the year. 20th Century Fox presents a Frank Yablans presentation. Silver Streak. Starring Gene Wilder, Jill Clayburgh, Richard Pryor, and Patrick McGoohan as Devereaux.
Why are we going so fast?
You've got a dead engineer in a runaway train that's going to hit Chicago in 15 minutes.
By plane, by train, by the edge of your seat, it's the most hilarious suspense ride of your life. Nothing can stop Silver Streak.
In 1940, San Francisco was the place to be. In those days, a stiff was a stiff, and a dick was still a detective.
Are you sure the police didn't follow you here?
I'm positive. They came with me.
Peter Falk is Lou Peckinpah.
Yeah.
He knows every cheap dame.
I like the sound of your name. Peckinpah. Know what I mean?
Every cheap joint.
Let's get them peepers.
and every cheap crook in town.
A spy?
He's Neil Simon's cheap detective.
Should I keep the change? No, I'll keep the change.
Nobody in their right mind would hire him, but the price is right.
Does $500 interest you?
Very much.
Then bring it. It's an expensive restaurant.
It's a case for mystery lovers.
The initials on this handkerchief are AP. What does AP stand for?
Alma Chalmers.
Chalmers begins with a C. This is a P.
Palmers. Alma Palmers.
It's for money lovers.
12th of all the wealth. Ancient China.
Music lovers.
Todolowski.
And murder lovers.
Gotcha. No, I think they got you.
It's not just whodunit.
Oh, boy.
It's who's in it. And Margaret.
I'm Jezebel Desire. Accent on the desire.
If you're not busy, Fred, I get off at 2.
Eileen Brennan.
Don't you think 2 is a good time to get off on?
Sid Caesar.
I came as fast as I could.
Stockard Channing. James Coco.
Just watch. I'd like to see somebody die regular on this case.
Dom DeLuise.
Does oatmeal have lumps?
Louise Fletcher.
I swallow my gum.
John Houseman.
One ginseng.
I'd rather have a brandy.
One ginseng is the waiter. One brandy, one ginseng.
Madeline Kahn.
It's Wanda Coleman.
But I don't care what your name is anymore. Just make one up so I know what to call you.
Vivian Purcell.
That's better.
Carmen Montenegro. That's my last one, I promised.
Fernando Lamas.
So the Black Fox and the Silver Wolf meet again,
And of course, you remember the Gray Rabbit and the Blue Chipmunk.
Paul Williams.
You call that a snap? That's a love tap. Now give it to yourself good. Go on. Give me that gun.
Marsha Mason. Abe Vigoda. Phil Silvers. And Nickel Williamson.
Delightfully gauche.
He's had enough.
It's Neil Simon's Cheap Detective. The movie was something for everyone, except the cabbie.
No tip. Death in the family.
I wish it was you.
Mitchum is still Marlowe, and murder is still murder. In Raymond Chandler's The Big Sleep, Robert Mitchum is
Philip Marlowe.
You shoot people, don't you, Mr. Marlowe?
I'm a private investigator.
It was about 11 o'clock in the morning. I was neat, clean-shaven, and sober. I was calling on 10 million pounds.
Sarah Miles is Charlotte. She's worth it.
Suppose you want money, too?
All I itch for is money. For 50 pounds a day, I dodge bullets. I risk my future, the hatred of the cops. Thank you very much. Put my card here on the table.
Why?
Why?
He's crazy.
Shut up, Agnes.
Joan Collins is Agnes. Blackmail's her business. Richard Boone is Camino. Boone kills. Candy Clark is Camilla. Candy kisses. Edward Fox is Brody. He's the mark. Oliver Reed is Eddie Mars. He's the mob. John Mills is Carson. He's the cop. And James Stewart is the general. His business with Marlowe is private.
I'm afraid my girls have all the usual vices.
You're cute.
Handsome, too.
I like you.
Mill likes you a lot. She has a great little body, doesn't she?
Yeah.
You know, you should see mine sometime.
I want my pictures, Joe.
You're playing too rough, Marlowe.
They're all soft, Marlowe, compared to you.
I told you the first time I met you, I'm a detective. I work at it, lady. I don't play at it.
Come to where the sex, blackmail, and murder is. Come to Marlowe Country. Mitchum is Marlowe in Raymond Chandler's The Big Sleep. Now, join the most brilliant detective of all time.
Hercule Poirot.
on a mysterious journey down the Nile to the great wonders of the world, where the biggest wonder of them all is whodunit.
I feel the presence of evil all about me.
Agatha Christie's Death on the Nile. Starring Peter Ustinov.
With me, it's the exercise of the little gray cells.
And nine star suspects. Betty Davis.
You perfectly foul French upstart.
Belgian upstart, please, Mother.
Mia Farrow.
I just want to put this gun right against her head. And then ever so gently, pull the trigger.
Angela Lansbury.
You see, I know all I tell you.
David Niven.
She must have known something about Annette Doyle's murderer.
Maggie Smith.
But why should I kill Mrs. Doyle?
George Kennedy.
You can't pin that on me.
Me?
Me!
Jack Warden.
So now you think that I?
Olivia Hussey. Lois Childs in Agatha Christie's...
Jackie!
Death on the Nile.
You know, Poirot, the way I see it, everybody could have done it. And everybody had a reason for doing it.
Of course. So you think you know, huh?
I know. This place is beginning to resemble a mortuary.
You see, we have been running in the wrong direction, you and I. We know almost all there is to know. Except that what we know seems incredible.
It's incredible.
Preposterous.
Outrageous.
Now, the most daring, the most deadly case of his career challenges Hercule Poirot.
And it was carefully planned.
To guess who in the world done it.
But I, Hercule Poirot, have eyes which notice everything.
Mystery in first class. Murder with style. Agatha Christie's... Death on the Nile.
Something stalks the streets. Something possessed of animal cunning and fury.
I understand you know something of the Whitechapel murders.
I have seen the man known as Jack the Ripper.
Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson plunge into the Victorian underworld, seeking the answers to the most puzzling case in the annals of crime. Who is Jack the Ripper?
Why does he let them keep you?
I don't know!
A story that at last reveals the identity of history's most elusive murderer. A stunning cast brought together with an astonishing story. One of the great screen entertainments in the classic tradition. Murder by Decree.